Hello, everybody. Patrick Glenn Nichols, Muscle Car Barn Finds. And today I'm coming to you just outside of Salt Lake City, Utah, where I come out here to accompany an individual to make a purchase on a 1970 Chevelle LS6 SS454 El Camino. The inspection did go very well, and the individual did make a purchase on this very beautiful shadow gray code 17B with black vinyl top LS6 SS454 automatic, code 755, bench seat on the column, automatic shift. Very, very pretty car from the Kansas City, Missouri assembly plant, built the third week of February 1970. Very, very cool. The car is numbers matching front to rear. The CRR engine is in place, dated 0130 for January the 30th, CRR with the correct font for the Kansas City, Missouri assembly plant. The CY transmission is still in place with the correct stamp on the side of the transmission. The VIN sequence stamp is still present. And then the October 30th, 1969 CRV rear axle is in the car as well. So we'll do my best to show you a thorough walk around video documentation of this car. It will be entered into the National LS6 registry and also be receiving my Patrick Glenn Nichols Muscle Car Barn Finds endorsement. So here we go. You can see the early style hood, which when I raise, you can see that, but it does have cowl induction and it was born with that. Car does retain the original assembly line, cowl induction air cleaner. And you can see here, like we've been over before, the hood pin cables are incorrect. Those are reproduction. It does have four T3 headlights still in place, and you can see the RPO V31 front bumper guards were optional, but are on the car as well. We've been over this before, but we'll touch on it again. You can see the hood pin plate is reproduction. The opening is too small. An original is about an eighth inch or more, a little bit bigger than that. So you can visually see the difference in the two, an assembly line GM to a reproduction. So let's go up with the hood and address quite a few factors under the hood as well. Car was born with the 331, so it will not have the heavy duty cooling four row radiator. It does have the three row. It is installed with a reproduction Harrison. And one way to tell that is down the fill tank, there will be no XP or date present. And there is not. So this is a reproduction radiator. If you can see right here, if you look, it does have an 834 alternator, which is incorrect. It should have an 837. A lot of times guys will take a much more affordable alternator and put the deep groove pulley on there because the 837 is such an expensive alternator that goes the correct unit for the LS6. 811 water pump is on the car still, a correct one, dated December the 9th, L99. I don't believe I'll be able to focus on that. As you know, we've been over it before, but we will touch on it. It does have the incorrect washer jar with the writing on the lid, all of which is incorrect. Moving around here, you can see it does have the correct 7-blade undated version of the LS6 fan, but it is equipped with the 919 replacement fan shroud. It should have the 165 uncut for the three-row radiator. I do believe all of the pulleys are reproduction except for the lower 291. If I can focus and show you, if you can see right there on the lower pulley, that spot weld circle, that is how you tell a reproduction will not have those spot welds. The 060 fan pulley does not have the teeth marks or the markings, the final. It's a reproduction. Same with the 105DD power steering pulley is also a reproduction. And the 458DA smog pulley is also reproduction. So a lot of reproduction pulleys, but we do have one original. You can see it is equipped with the early style smog, but it does have the incorrect 158, a correct early style top hose here would have the 937LN, Larry Nancy, 937LN. So that is incorrect. Another thing I can get you to focus your attention on, right in this area of the front of the intake, you can see there is no Winter's Foundry snowflake. That is your first indication that it is a reproduction 569 intake manifold, and it does not have the stake mark, which would be right on this first ledge, which indicates all of the original GM ones. They do have a stake mark on this front ledge. So we have no stake mark and no Winter Snowflake logo. So we have a reproduction intake manifold. We'll focus on the carburetor, which is not real easy sometimes. I can tell you right now what it says. It's supposed to have the GR4492 list, and it does. And the date on this particular carburetor is dated 9/02 for 1969, October 2nd week. But again, there will be photos of these components posted on my social media, which always follows my walk around documentation. This is my form of a report. I don't do reports like I've stated before in the past. I'll show you the casting date on this cylinder head, L89, December the 8th, 1969. Definitely falls in line with this engine, which is built January the 30th, 1970. You can see 291 is correct over here. Show you the driver's side. Here we are, L1 of 9, December the 1st. And just to prove, we will flash on the 291. You can see there. Does have the correct 293 coil. If you can focus your attention back here on the back of the intake, back on the firewall area, you can see right in this area, you see the tack wire is stretched really tight. That's incorrect. It has the tack wire in the wrong hole. And the cowl induction should be down there. It should swap places. They have those two in the wrong location. Get you to focus on the 9391 power brake booster, which is definitely correct. The plating on it is a little overdone. It was never really that gold. It was a more of a silvery CAD plate, zinc CAD looking material or plating. It never really was that gold. So this is a little bit overdone. If you see the CT code on the hose there, that is incorrect. It should be CN instead of CT. Moving along, give you one more shot of the early style cowl induction hood, which is a really nice example. And now I'll do the best that I can to give you a good shot of this engine stamp. I can hold steady for you. So it does read T for Tonawanda, 01 for January, 30 for the 30th, and CRR for automatic. And you can see the VIN sequence at 10K, Kansas City, Missouri, 169069, as is the last VIN sequence of this El Camino. Okay, moving along a little bit, you can see that the restore did a pretty good job of duplicating the process around the heater box, which is very common on a Kansas City, Missouri car. That is really nice there. That is a pretty good job of that duplication. And now I'll move along over here to the cowl tag, which we always do. And right off, you know, right here while we're at it, you can see that the BB master cylinder is not here. It does need that. So this master cylinder is a replacement. Hopefully we can do a decent job of focusing on this where I can read it. Again, the photos will be posted on my social media, but again, you can see the 136-80-755, the 17B for shadow gray black vinyl top, and then the build date of 02C, the third week of February, and the infamous L. So we will move along around this El Camino. One quick shot, you can see it does have the incorrect exhaust manifold on this side with the front ledge. It should be smooth on a 70 model on the driver's side exhaust manifold. So this one is definitely not dated correctly to this car. Car does have January wheels all the way around, AO, which is correct for this February car. Moving along to the interior, which I'll give you a quick shot real quick of the 169069. Right in there. Okay. And some pretty good shots of down the driver's side of this really beautiful restoration on this car. So let's address some of the interior options. The car was born with deluxe seat belts. Majority of the interior is reproduction aside from the dash and the dash pad. You can see we got the 51st week of 69. That date should be pretty close. I would think it'd be a little closer than that, but you can see the tags are reproduction. So there's no way to tell what the original tags were dated. Does have a reproduction manufactured by GM, VinTag, Vince decal and the door jamb. The dash is a very nice, an original piece, but I've been over this before. I do believe that the trim around the gauges is a little bit too shiny chrome, in my opinion. I've seen a many really nice low mile cars that's never been out in the sun, and it just simply was never that shiny. It had a little bit more silver tint to it than that, but the dash itself is just beautiful, a nice original beautiful 70 Chevelle dash. The seat is really, really nice. So this is a nice reproduction cover that shows up well. You can see the reproduction SS emblem. And the steering horn shroud is a 69 pebble grain, which is incorrect. Should have a 70 style, as they call it, the camera vane, which matches the print on that dash. Should be the same print on this horn shroud. That is a 69 horn shroud. Incorrect. So we will move along here now. Whoever put this final roof on did a very good job. I applaud them. They did not put the foam underneath. It is vinyl straight to metal, just like the factory would have installed it. That was a very nice job of the installation of the vinyl roof. Now I'll just simply show you just how nice the paint and body is on the bed of this El Camino. It's beautiful. The car, I had the luxury of having this car up on a lift a few hours ago. I can tell you the frame and the chassis, the body, the rear end, all of the restoration is really, really nice underneath the chassis of this car. Moving along to the rear, give you some nice shots of the rear of this beautiful LS6 El Camino. And now on to the passenger side. And I can give you a good, try to do my best to focus down the side of it, but it is very straight. and very nice, a pretty car. If you can see, the SS wheel center caps are the replacement. They are not the deep style, which is assembly line correct. It does not have the correct wheel center caps. I will show you the inside of the passenger side to complete the documentation thoroughly. Car just has a standard AM radio with a center speaker. That is correct. Very nice job. And then I'll show you behind the seat and the spare tire. You can see it does have some overspray on this restored wheel. Although I have seen some sloppy original paint wheels that have some overspray, especially on the front, and even some drops of paint on original paint wheels, but nevertheless, that overspray should not be there. Moving along. Finish the rest of the passenger side. The car hat does have replacement glass all the way around, new glass. Again, January of 70 Supersport wheels. And here we are back to the engine bay. And I believe I've addressed most of the incorrect factors under the hood. Does have the correct style cowl induction solenoid. The routing that they have of the cowl induction vacuum hose is incorrect. The vacuum tube that goes to the automatic transmission looks to be like it's been painted silver. That should be bare steel, of course. Car does not have an original 8437 distributor, which is very common, especially with how rare and how expensive those distributors are today. The horns are dated to the car, so they are correct and appear to be the original items that have been with the car for quite some time, 53 years now. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video of this 1970 Chevelle SS454 El Camino. A purchase was just made on this car today. I did accompany the buyer. This is a fully matching SS454 LS6 El Camino. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you need assistance authenticating your 1970 Chevelle SS in any form, in any horsepower, please reach out to me at pnichols26@yahoo.com or Patrick Glenn Nichols at Muscle Car Barn Finds on Facebook and YouTube. It's a great way to contact me. I really appreciate all of the participation on my channel. Please like, share, comment, subscribe. I really appreciate that. My endorsement is really taking off. And I really, if you're interested in that, don't hesitate to reach out. Again, I hope you enjoyed the video of this 1970 Chevelle rare SS454 LS6 that will be going into the National Registry. And I will be issuing my endorsement. Thanks so much. More videos on the way.